Call 704-732-9577.
All right, good afternoon. Welcome to high school basketball here on 1050 AM, KPCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app. My name is Derek Smith. I'm joined alongside, as always, Evan Ludwig for tonight's Renata Audemars broadcast of North Surry and Lincolnton in the third round of the Class 2A state playoffs. Bring in Evan, as always, and Evan, Wolves on a roll. Won the conference championship in the tournament in Hickory last Friday night. Won a first-round game Tuesday. A matchup with East Lincoln on Thursday. Here we are, their fourth game, basically in a week, with a chance to go to the regionals on the line next weekend.
Yeah, and you know, this is what the conference championship kind of prepares you for. You want to be the conference champion, but also you're playing a lot of games in just a short week here, and that's something that we don't see from high school athletes that they're used to. You know, we usually see this with NBA players, that they have to play at least three or four games a week. This is something out of the ordinary here for high school players, and that's what makes the high school basketball playoffs so fun, and I think that's what creates a lot of upsets, Derek.
67-59, second round win against East Lincoln two nights ago. Close, late, but pulled out the win. Obviously, East Lincoln had a guy out, their second leading scorer out pretty much the entire second half with a concussion. Went on to win that game. Cameron Dollar kind of willed his team to stay close for a while, but Lincoln too much for East Lincoln on Thursday night.
Yeah, and you know, once Colson Leach went down with an injury, East was just trying to force the ball inside to Cameron, and Coach Cowley and the Lincolnton Wolves recognized that, and they were getting aggressive, trying to steal the ball, pickpocket the ball, and they were getting a lot of turnovers and a lot of fast break points off of it. And I think that was the main contributing factor that won the game for the Wolves 48 hours ago here at Lincolnton High School, and as wider here tonight against North Surry.
Surratt, 31 points. Robinson, 13 points. Young Cheryl had 10 points. Cowie was 6. Couple of three-point shots early for Cowie, then kind of quiet. Givens, 5. Harris, 2. Cameron Dollar, 42 points for his team. Pretty much the entire offense the other night. Dollar with 7. Leach with 6. Horn with 3. Bean with 1. And again, he couldn't quite do it all himself the other night.
No, I mean, if your coach Ashley, who we just heard is now no longer the head coach at East Lincoln after 1 year, you can't get mad at Cameron, because he did everything he could to win the game for you. 42 points, 8 rebounds, and he didn't get an assist because they were passing, trying to pass it to him to score the whole entire game. So, you know, if you're East Lincoln or you're Cameron Dollar, it's like, what else can I do, you know? I did all I could, and we still lost by 8 points.
Lincolnton 25-1, one loss to West Caldwell seems like months ago. I mean, this team really has had a heck of a season, no matter what happens tonight or the rest of the way out.
Yeah, but then again, this team is really wanting the state championship more than anything else, and I believe that if they, I know they made it, this is where they got eliminated last year, the last 2 years actually. They want to make it past this fairground and go to the state championship game, because they know this is basically players of that are a lot of seniors here. Sage Surratt, you look at Young Cheryl, Langdon Givens. A lot of these guys joined the team because Sage Surratt was on it, and they wanted to maybe make a state championship run.
North Surry, a 5 seed. Lincoln in the 3 seed, to the top 2 seeds in the bottom half of this bracket advance, as you would expect. Maybe the toughest test so far this postseason for Lincoln tonight, with North Surry coming in this place.
Yeah, you can make a great argument about that. I know a lot of people would say East Lincoln, but then again, you've played that team 3 times before the playoffs, so you're kind of used to them. This North Surry team you haven't faced, and this North Surry team comes into this game right here 24-4, so they got the same amount of wins, just 3 more losses. They've had a lot of challenges this year too, and they've actually beat the team that has beaten Lincolnton and West Caldwell, and they beat them pretty good earlier in the year during non-conference play. And this North Surry team, you know what scares people down the stretch in playoffs? When you have to go against teams that are very experienced. This is probably the most experienced team we've seen in basketball this year, Derek. 9 seniors on this team for North Surry. Most of them are their key players.
All right, Renata Audemars broadcast North Surry Lincolnton here on the Carolina Trust Bank courtside pregame show. Back for more here in just a second. High school basketball, 1050 AM, KDCBroadcasting.com, and the Ustream app on your mobile device. Back in a moment.
When Auto Owners Insurance was founded in 1916, the world was quite different. Yet with all that's changed, our commitment to be there when you need us most hasn't. By teaming up with independent agents, we've made a difference for generations of customers, and will for generations to come. by making a difference every day, 100 years seem to go by in a flash.
Your local Auto Owners Insurance Agency is Mooney Insurance Agency, located at 528 East Main Street in Maiden. Call 828-428-8231. It's the best deal of the year right now at Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC in Lincolnton. Save big during Abernathy's pre-owned inventory blowout sale. They all gotta go. Check out the great deals on cars, trucks, SUVs, and vans. Save thousands of dollars. Find out why more people buy again and again from Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC in Lincolnton. Come experience the Abernathy Advantage today at Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC, 1445 East Main Street in Lincolnton, online at AbernathyChevrolet.com. The Start Something New sales event is underway at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge in Lincolnton. Find out how you can get $3,000 total cash or 0% financing for 60 months and $2,500 bonus cash on the new 2016 Dodge Charger. Don't miss it. The Start Something New sales event going on now at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge, 1442 East Main Street in Lincolnton. It's time to start something new at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge in Lincolnton.
The voice of Woody Durham calling the Hills games brought bright smiles to the faces of Tar Heel fans everywhere. Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton will brighten your smiles with professional cosmetic dentistry and smile enhancement procedures for everyone. Even Duke fans will smile at the work of this Tar Heel. The office of Dr. John L. Cloninger III is located at 904 Doncha Drive. For an appointment, call 704-735-0765. That's 704-735-0765. And John III says best wishes to all high school athletes.
It's the Subway Sub of the Day. Each day of the week, you get a different 6-inch sub for just $3.50. Monday, the Sweet Onion Chicken Teriyaki Sub. Tuesday, the Oven Roasted Chicken Sub. Wednesday, the Turkey Breast Sub. Thursday, the Italian BMT Sub. Friday, the Tuna Sub. Saturday, the Black Forest Ham Sub. And Sunday, the Meatball Marinara Sub. Your choice, just $3.50. The Sub of the Day from Subway in Boca City and the Walmart in Lincolnton.
You don't pull a mask off an old Lone Ranger, and you don't mess around with Jim.
Drew, this new city just makes me miss home, man. Go get a sweet tea from McDonald's. They make it fresh, sweet, and it's icy cold, just like your mom's. But I miss home, home.
Oh, so you miss your mom telling you to make sure your room's clean? Or
close the fridge, Ryan, and stop letting all the cool air out.
Or
turn them lights off,
Ryan. All right, got it. The sweet tea is just right. But you know I'm going to tell my mom you got jokes.
No, no, don't.
This is no joke. Stop by McDonald's and get a large sweet tea for just a dollar all summer long. Large sweet tea, just a buck. Price and participation may vary. Limited time only.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina.
The Orange Opportunity Sales Event is underway at Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. Come in now and ask about 0% financing for 84 months on select Kubota tractors with a big 6-year warranty. So come in for all the details. Also, pick up this week's What's Up Shopper for the spring service coupons. Save from $10 to $200 off with your coupon. Just pick up this week's What's Up Shopper at Parker Farm Service, located at 126 Bessie Drive off Oak Grove Road and a Highway 74 bypass in Kings Mountain.
All right, back we are. Derek Smith, Evan Ludwig, Granada Automall broadcast, North Surry and Lincolnton here, Class 2A, third-round playoff match on the Carolina Trust Bank courtside pregame show. Lincolnton got here by beating Lexington last Tuesday, 95-75. Knocked off East Lincoln for the fourth time this season Thursday night here in the third round. 25-1 as the number 3 seed. North Surry defeated Drawn Tuesday night, 95-69. Defeated the 24 seed Randleman Thursday at their place, 24-4. They did what they were supposed to do. You got to figure with that bracket being the way it was, them, the 5 seed atop this lower part of the 2A bracket.
And, you know, I don't think any of those teams has as much senior experience as this North Surry team has, who has 9 total seniors, and I think all 4 of their leading scorers in points per game are all seniors as well. So We've been saying the whole year, basically, Lincolnton's got some of the most veteran experience out of anyone out here in this area, but then here comes this North Surry team who has a lot more seniors than Lincolnton does. So I'm going to be interested to see what this North Surry team brings, because I've been hearing a lot of great things about them here to the, you know, the stages leading up to this event right here.
Give us the names to watch tonight and their point totals, their statistics as we get set for this broadcast in just a few moments.
All right, the leading scorer for the Greyhounds of North Surry is Carter Phillips, number four, who comes into this game with 22 points per game, 7.8 rebounds, and 3.6 assists. And then you have Mason Hawks, number three, with 20 points per game right on the dot, 5.5 assists per game, and 3 rebounds per game. Then take a little bit down to number 10, Kendall Tucker, 14.5 points per game and 2.5 rebounds per game. And number 12, Casey Hall, with 11.6 points per game and 4.6 rebounds per game. The only weakness I can really see on this team right now is they lack size, which we've been saying about East Lincoln, and they've been able in the past years to get away with some of their size challenges. But I don't think there's a guy that's that extremely tall that can be a low post center that can really dominate this game, like we've seen certain low post centers in the past dominate this game against some of the teams that East Lincoln and Lincolnton have faced. Like, remember Brandon Ingram, he was 6'9". They actually had a couple guys. This team, I don't think, has anyone above 6'3", so that's going to be an interesting thing to see how that plays out tonight, Derek.
For Lincolnton, Chris Robinson, the freshman, been outstanding, can hit the three-point shot, does a lot of things to help this team free throw line as well.
Yeah, he's the complete opposite of what you'd think a freshman would be. You'd think he'd be nervous. He'd think he'd be extremely raw, and I think there are certain times where he can look like that, and maybe sometimes we just don't notice it, but he is well mature in his basketball playing as the Lincolnton Wolves come out here right now. He's going to be a great Lincolnton Wolf for a long time to come, I believe.
Sage Surratt, so physical, runs the floor, had a great night rebounding, can hit the three-point shot. I mean, he is who you would expect him to be, one of the top players in the state.
Yeah, and I kind of look at him a little bit like a James Harden in the NBA, because I have not seen a player be this good at getting to the free throw line and driving to the lane and getting pump fakes like Sage Surratt does. It's incredible, and I think it's highlighted it this year more than any other year when he was at East Lincoln, and he's just proven how talented of a player he is, and that's why I still think he's better at basketball than he is at football, even though he's amazing at both of them.
Robbie Cowley, the coach's son, 6'5", can hit the three-point shot, and again, he's pretty good in the middle for this team as well.
Yeah, he has been quiet at some stretches when it comes to scoring, but when he gets going, that completely opens things up for Sage Surratt and Chris Robinson. I feel like Robbie Cowley's got to have another good start like he did Tuesday night, except he's going to have to continue and get more shots up there.
Young Cheryl, the charitable transfer, 6'5", doesn't score a whole lot, but plays a good bit of defense and can cause some problems as well.
Can get a lot of offensive putbacks too, and he's really been scoring in this playoffs, gotten double digits in both games, which we haven't seen much of throughout the season. So they're going to have Young Cheryl continue to get offensive rebounds and get double-digit scoring once again tonight.
Landon Gibbons, maybe the most quiet of the starting five, but very important in his role on this team as well.
Well, his role, play defense. Play defense. Don't let any the wings get good scoring going. And then you wait on the baseline for Sage to maybe pass it to you inside while they're both the defense of the opposing team is just focused on Sage. Sage will pass it to Langdon, get an easy layup, an easy 2 points. That seems to be the formula they have for Langdon Givens. Defense and waiting on the baseline to drive to it to get some points.
6-7, Tyshawn Harris and Skylar Evans coming in off the bench and doing some nice things as well, giving the other guys some rest.
Both of those guys are athletes. I like Tyshawn Harris as he's 5'10", 5'9", but he can hop up there almost to the rim. They had an alley-oop, I believe it was Thursday night or Tuesday night, where he got jumped up to the rim and laid it up off of an inbounds pass. Tyshawn Harris has got, he plays above his size, in my opinion. And I think that's great to have for a bench player.
All right, tip-off shortly after 7 o'clock. We're not on all broadcast. North Surry, Lincoln in Class 2A, third-round matchup. Carolina Trust Bank pregame courtside show continues after we break for this commercial timeout. High school basketball on 1050 AM, KDCBroadcasting.com, and the Eastern app on your mobile device. Back in a moment.
The lowest prices on quality automobiles just got lower at Milholland Automotive in Lincolnton. Milholland Automotive in Lincolnton is having a year-end clearance sale. Prices have been slashed on every unit in stock. Save thousands of dollars on your next vehicle. At Milholland Automotive in Lincolnton, you get 1.9% financing with approved credit. and they are the king of zero money down. Plus a warranty on every vehicle. Mill Holland Automotive, 423 West Main Street in Lincolnton, online at millhollandautomotive.com. Dine in, carry out, or use their convenient drive-through window at Mitchum's Kitchen in Vail. You'll find Northbrook's finest in food. As a matter of fact, the finest food anywhere. And for a special treat, order one of the big bloomin' onions. From barbecue to fish to steaks, hamburgers and hot dogs, they've got it all at Mitchum's Kitchen in Vail. Open for breakfast, too. And be sure to like them on Facebook for their specials and Sunday lunch menus. And they do catering, no matter how big or small. Call Mitchum's Kitchen today, located at the intersection of Highway 27 West and Highway 274 in Vail.
I said, where I come from, it's cornbread and chicken. Where I come from.
Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton will brighten your smiles with professional cosmetic dentistry and smile enhancement procedures for everyone. Even Duke fans will smile at the work of this Tar Heel. The office of Dr. John L. Cloninger III is located at 904 Dodger Drive. For an appointment, call 704-735-0765. That's 704-735-0765. And John III says best wishes to all high school athletes.
Maybe a punctuation mark on a career night for Bryce Johnson.
ATV fans, the 2017 Yamaha Grizzly and Kodiak 700s are at Full Throttle Power Sports in Lowell. The more powerful than ever Grizzly is engineered for the all-day trail excursions on the toughest terrain. And the Kodiak 700 delivers class-best performance and value, starting at just $69.99. Visit Full Throttle Power Sports today. Yamaha ATVs, real world tough. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 at I-85 in Lowell.
You don't pull a mask off an old Lone Ranger and you don't mess around with Jim.
Breakfast time is the right time to be at the Home Place Restaurant, Highway 27, 2 miles west of Lincolnton. Check out their breakfast specials this month. Get your choice of a breakfast sandwich along with tea or coffee for just $3.99. But that's not all. Try their Big Country Breakfast. 2 eggs, your choice of bacon, sausage, liver mush, and a pancake. All for just $4.25 at the Home Place Restaurant. Highway 27, 2 miles west of Lincolnton. Now open for Sunday lunch, too.
Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
Now's the time to head to West End Sales in Vail for some great deals on Coyote. Like the Coyote UTV with top and winch starting at $11,900 and get 0% financing. And see the new Coyote 3510 34 horsepower tractor, only $17,900. And the big Coyote RX Series 4-wheel drive tractor with cab and loader starting at $37,000. And see the big line of Big Tex trailers, over 40 in stock, 3.99% financing for 54 months with approved credit. West End Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail, online at westendsales.com.
Sleep apnea is the interruption of sleep by a blockage to breathing. 8 million Americans go undiagnosed for sleep apnea. Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton can help you with sleep apnea problems. John III is a member of the American Academy of Dental Sleep Medicine. He can help you now overcome the symptoms of obstructive sleep apnea, such as excessive daytime sleep, loud snoring, episodes of breathing cessation where you stop breathing, dry mouth and sore throat, morning headaches, insomnia, attention problems, and more. John III is concerned that patients don't know there are treatments for obstructive sleep apnea, from CPAP to dental appliances or even surgery. John III offers a free consultation for anyone with symptoms of sleep apnea. Just call 704-735-0765 or come by 904 Doncha Drive in Lincolnton to make an appointment. Sleep longer, smile brighter, live happier. Let Dr. John L. Cloninger III put his 21 years of dentistry experience to work for you.
You don't pull a mask off an old Lone Ranger.
All right, welcome back. Derek and Evan with you, getting set for Not Autumn All broadcast of North Surry and Lincolnton, round three, Class 2A state playoff matchup here on a Saturday night at the gym in Lincolnton. Elsewhere tonight, girls basketball, Maiden at Smoky Mountain. Maiden had a test against Lincolnton, surpassed that test kind of close the other night, going up to Smoky Mountain. Those girls are tall. Their fundamental will be a tough test up there in the mountains for the Blue Devils this evening.
Yeah, driving 3 hours up to Cullowhee or Silva, whichever way you put it. It's definitely going to be a tough challenge. You know, so we've seen Smoky Mountain boys and girls always being a tough team to play in the playoffs or throughout any type of the season during basketball season. And it's definitely going to be tough for Grace Connell and the rest of those Blue Devils to get the job done. But, hey, they've beaten Lincolnton and East Lincoln within the last week. So those are two extremely talented teams, even with Lincolnton having two injuries to their key players.
Boys 1A West Montgomery at Lincoln Charter. Lincoln Charter so close last year to a state championship on a mission to get back there and win it this year.
Yeah, they lost Trey Johnson, but they got guys like London England to come in. And they haven't missed a beat. As long as they got Schubert, I think they're going to have a good chance to win a state championship in that 1A bracket.
Shelby back in the third round again this year against Lake Norman Charter over in Mecklenburg County on WOHS AM 1390, 101.5 FM, our sister station. What about that matchup tonight?
You know, Shelby, they just came off an upset beating Thomasville on the road. They've had to travel throughout the whole playoffs, and I don't think they're scared of Lake Norman Charter. They made it to the fourth round last year, and it's quite possible they can make it to the fourth round again this year because of Quay Kimball, an amazing athlete, and it's I think, somewhat criminal. I know his size is smaller. He's 5'9", but I think it's somewhat criminal that he hasn't had, I don't think, the looks that a player like him should usually get.
We're at college basketball tomorrow here on The Boss. Butler at Xavier, 3:15 right here on 10:50 a.m., also, Hornets basketball tomorrow night from the West Coast at the Clippers, 9:30 on 10:50 a.m. And the big race at Daytona tomorrow right here at 1 o'clock on WCSL 1590. Changes this year in the point system. What do you think about the whole thing with NASCAR changing this thing this year? New sponsor as well.
Yeah, new sponsor, Monster Energy Cup Series. I like the sponsor name. I think it, you know, gravitates towards the NASCAR fans. I also like the segment runs, but the only gripe I have about the segment runs is I think it would work better if they didn't have the whole playoff system anymore. But, hey, if that's the only thing I can gripe about it, it's better because NASCAR has made some silly moves in the past.
All right, National Anthem coming up. We'll step aside, let them do that. Come back, and the starting lineups will be next. And tipping off this game, this is high school basketball at 10:50 a.m., KBCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app on your mobile device. Back in a moment, everybody.
You're in your dome, mills around with Jim.
Think your dream home is out of reach? Think again. At Silver Point Homes in Lincolnton, they provide quality custom construction and the luxury amenities you want at an exceptional value. Whether you're a first-time home buyer or an empty nester looking to downsize, we have the perfect home for you. Visit SilverPointHomes.com to learn more or stop by our Lincolnton Sales Center to tour our model homes. Let our friendly staff help you visualize your dream. Silver Point Homes, making your dream home a reality. New models now on display. Silver Point Homes, East Main Street, Lincolnton.
It's a Husqvarna closeout sale on the remaining 2016 model Husqvarna mowers, including the Husqvarna zero-turn mowers at Al Lane Kubota and Motorsports in Lincolnton. Come on in now for their preseason specials. Ask about 0% financing for up to 42 months. Right now, there's a big selection to choose from. And Al Lane is having a chainsaw clearance sale. Prices have been slashed. Get ready for springtime with a trip to Al Lane Kubota and Motorsports, Highway 27 east of Lincolnton at the Highway 73 intersection, and online at AlLaneMotorsports.com.
I said where I come from, it's cornbread and chicken where I come from.
The President's Day sale is underway at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. I cannot tell a lie. You can't beat the deals found at Renato Auto Mall in Shelby. Come in now and take 0% APR financing up to 66 months plus $1,000 cash bonus on the 2016 Kia Optimus. Take $9,000 off MSRP on the new 2016 GMC Sierra 1500 truck. And buy a new 2017 Honda HR-V LX for $183 a month. 0.9% financing up to 60 months. At Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall. First Federal Savings Bank has been serving Lincoln County for over 75 years. Customer service is a priority at First Federal Savings Bank, where they want to get to know you by name. First Federal Savings Bank has the convenience, products, and services of larger banks with hometown people that you see throughout your community. They live here, they work here, and this community matters to the people at First Federal Savings Bank. First Federal Savings Bank has four convenient locations in downtown Lincolnton, Bogart City, Denver, and West Lincoln. Stop in and visit and see what First Federal Savings Bank has to offer you. Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
There's a storm coming. We may not know its path, but your independent auto owner's insurance agent knows. No matter what happens, we'll be there when you need us most. Strong through every storm. That's how it's been for our first 100 years. And how it will be for generations to come.
Your local Auto Owners Insurance Agency is East Lincoln Insurance Agency on Highway 16 in Denver. Call 704-483-3243.
In my mind, I'm gone.
And back here at Lincolnton High School, this is Renata Onomal's broadcast of high school basketball on WLON 1050 AM. Excuse me there. I want to thank Carolina Trust Bank for presenting the pregame show for us. And now the starting lineups for tonight's game. First, for the visiting North Surry Greyhounds, number 3, Mason Hawks, number 4, Carter Phillips, number 10, Kendall Tucker, number 12, Casey Hull, and number 24, Ethan Simmons. Now the starting lineup for the Lincolnton Wolves, the usual lineup for the Wolves. Number 22, Chris Robinson. Number 30, Sage Surratt. Number 33, Robbie Cowie. Number 34, Young Cheryl. And running out the starting five for the Lincolnton Wolves is Langdon Givens. Coach Cowie looking to make this the third time to charm, trying to get past the third round, as this is where he's been eliminated the last two rounds, Derek.
All right, well, we saw a lot of East Lincoln fans here the other night. Likewise, the North Surry fans have made a couple-hour trip down here on a Saturday night to take this in.
And I think that's the key Saturday. It benefits that this game's going to be on a Saturday here. And we've got a jam-packed crowd, hardly any. I don't see many seats available. You're really going to have to squeeze in. I know these North Surry people have. And it's great to see the visitors travel, and travel very well, dead North Surry.
All right, introductions are taking place down below us. Lincolnton now being introduced. The students are on their feet over across the way. Lincolnton fans, the other side, they packed this gym. North Surry fans over on our side as we're high atop their side of the bleachers. Making some noise in here tonight. We'll set to tip this thing off in just a moment.
Yeah, North Surry is in all blue tonight, rocking some Under Armour jerseys. I think that's the first time we've seen Under Armour jerseys at a basketball game this year, Derek. They're looking mighty spiffy.
Should Lincolnton win tonight, they would be back at home on Tuesday night as the highest left seed in this bracket. So the high seed has certainly helped them to this point and could help them with one more game should they be victorious tonight back here on Tuesday night for the fourth round.
Yeah, and they've had to fight for the first two games, specifically the second one, but they haven't had the easy, you know, cupcake schedule in this playoff bracket like some other teams have in years past. They've actually had to go against tough teams, starting in that first round against Lexington, who was 11-13, but they're in a tough conference.
All right, North Surry wearing a Duke blue, moving right to left on your radio dial, your video screen. Lincolnton all white, trimmed in the gold, moving left to right toward the front of the gym here at the high school in Elstown. Appreciate you stopping by, joining us tonight. Stick around for some great basketball action, and we are underway. Chaff control to North Surry. They've got the basketball to begin the game tonight. Work over on the right wing. Come back up top. Faked a shot. Didn't take it. Back in the corner left side. Penetrate the lane. One-handed hanging shot. No good. Draw a foul. That'll put Mason Hawks in the line to shoot two quick free throws for the Greyhounds.
And that's what you want to do, North Surry. If you can't get the points, get the foul and then go to the Eddie's Auto Parts free throw line. And that's what Mason Hawks did. Driving to the lane and gets the foul on Chris Robinson.
First shot up and no good. Left it short. We're just underway on a Saturday night in Lincolnton. Round 3, Class 2A state playoffs. Second one on the way. It is good. Made 1-2. 1-0. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Greyhounds on top. Some backcourt pressure now by North Surry. Robinson trying to break it. Sage sat in the forecourt of the dribble. He'll take it up, give it up to Givens. Up and good off the glass, in between the lane between two defenders, and it's 2-1. Wolves on top, just underway. 7:28 left in the first quarter of play. They work over on the right side now. 3-point shot is up and good. Let's see who knocked that back. That was Carter Phillips with a three-point shot. They're on top 4-2. Against the backcourt pressure, they get the turnover. Mason Hawks may take it coast-to-coast. Give it up. Lay it good. That was Ethan Simmons on the transition off the turnover. 6-2. Greyhounds on top.
Lincolnton wasn't ready for this full-court pressure, and they're getting it as now Saint Surratt fouled. Fouled by Ethan Simmons.
Not a shooting foul. Simmons quite the hairdo.
Yeah, bring it back to the mullet. Everything that's old is new again, Derek.
I heard that. All right, here comes Sage Surratt. Greyhounds back in their defense, a zone defense. Surratt on the left wing. Drives the lane, pass across to Givens. Givens up, baseline, missed the shot. Rebound tapped around for. Mason Hawks will take it. 2-on-3 break, pull up in between a defender. Charge! Langdon Givens planting the feet, drawing the charge, and that'll be Lincolnton basketball.
That's the main way you stop a fast break is to get a charge and just hope you had your feet planted, and that's what Langdon Givens did there. Took one for the team.
All right, again, the backcourt pressure by the Greyhounds. In it goes to Surratt. Back on D, drops the North Surry team. Up top to Robinson. Right wing to Cowie. Cross court it goes to Sage Surratt. Surratt inside the lane. Foul line shot up off the glass. Good, he banked it. And the bank is open on a Saturday night, and it's 6-4. Lincolnton with a shot just outside the lane. Here comes Mason Hawks, the point guard. Gives it over to Simmons. Over on the corner, baseline, out of bounds. It'll belong to Lincolnton.
Yeah, Phillips just lost control of his dribble there, and it bounced on out of bounds, causing a turnover.
6:03, first quarter play. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Greyhounds on top, 6-4. Cowley can't get the basketball in. It's going to be Greyhound basketball.
Great defense there by Simmons and Hall. Just staying on Sage Surratt and Chris Robinson, making it hard for Cowie to even inbound some pass.
Couldn't get the timeout called. Cowie having some trouble. Beneath their own basket, the Greyhounds will see what they can do. Inbounds, it goes up top to Simmons. Over to Phillips. He'll take it up and good. Carter Phillips makes it 8-4. Greyhounds have doubled up on Lincolnton. Here is Sage Surratt, three, top of the key, no good. Rebound, fought for, brought down by the Greyhounds. Mason Hawks on the run, transition, layup, good. This time that was up and good by Kendall Tucker, 10-4, Greyhounds up by six. Surratt loses the basketball. Here comes Mason Hawk, 2-on-1 break. Hawk layup, no good. Rebound knocked out of bounds to lead North Surrey's basketball.
North Surry coming out with a lot of fire here, playing hard defense, and they're trying to get quick steals, and that's going to force a timeout by Lincolnton.
Absolutely. We'll step aside as well. Timeout on the court. Back in a moment. High school basketball, 10:50 a.m. KDCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app. Back in a moment, everybody.
It's like going on vacation without leaving town. At the Glen Oaks Golf Club in Maiden, sure there's golf, but there's a whole lot more, like their swimming pool, driving range, picnic shelter, and their new clubhouse, featuring a snack bar and a big banquet room. Great for weddings, receptions, class, and family reunions. So for a fun day of golf and much, much more, see Glen Oaks Golf Course. Call 828-428-2451. 828-428-2451. Online at glenoaksgolf.com.
Who do you think you are?
Thirteen to four on the inbounds play after the timeout. The Greyhounds go on top with 5:12 to go. First quarter play, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Wolves in trouble here early. Smoke.
Yeah, just making baskets and getting steals on defense. Defense leading offense for the Greyhounds right now.
All right, here is Givens. Givens bounce pass in wide, knocked away by Simmons on the break again. Here they come, way up, nug up and in. Carter Phillips, 15-4. Uh-oh, watch out. Greyhounds really rocking and rolling here early tonight. Here's Chris Robinson, left wing in the corner. Come up top to Cowie, now to Sage, three, Sage, good. Got a good roll. 15-7, 4:33, first quarter of play, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Wolves still down pretty good here early.
Yeah, just need to get it within five at least. Just trim that lead down before the end of the first quarter.
Here's Hawks in the corner, shot up by Kendall Tucker. Good. Is that a two or a three? Only a two, I believe. 18-7. They're hitting everything. Was the three?
Yes.
Chris Robinson will drive between two defenders, and there will be a foul on the floor. Should be an inbounds play, I believe, for Lincolnton.
That foul is on Casey Hull. That's his first. Now we're seeing our first check-in. Skylar Evans checking in. Also got a check-in for North Surry. That is number 14, Chase Chandler.
Givens comes out. Cowie to inbounds beneath the Lincolnton basket. Couldn't get it in last time on the other end. Goes high atop near midcourt to Surratt. Surratt gets a pick on the left wing, come up top to Cowie. Cowie drives out to Sayes, thought about a shot, didn't take it. Now he thinks again, comes up, hanging shot in the lane, no good, off badly, didn't hit anything. Not a great shot by Sage. Here is Mason Hawks, the point guard. As you mentioned, Chase Chandler is in the game. Three, top of the key, missed short by Phillips. Rebound, Chris Robinson. Robinson in the forecourt. He may take it because he loses the basketball. Down the floor, it'll be a layup. Good. That went to Kendall Tucker, 20-7. Oh, my gosh. 3 minutes and 29 seconds in the first quarter. Wolves down by 13. Here's Robinson. Had the three-point shot blocked out of bounds.
Everything going North Surry's way right now. Lincolnton just can't find rhythm, and North Surry is getting causing turnovers right now.
Talk about some momentum out of the gate, Smoke. Wow.
I haven't seen anything like this before.
Not all year long. Cowie, back court, he goes to Sage on the inbound play. 3:20 to go, first quarter play, 20-7.
Someone's got to create some offense other than Sage for Lincolnton here.
North Surry on top big. Here's Cowie. Knocked away again. Stolen away. Here comes Mason Hawks. Gives it up. Layup. Good. That went to Carter Phillips. 22-7. Cowie's got to take another timeout. We'll pause as well. High school basketball. Keep it VAM. KDCBroadcasting.com. The Ustream app. Back in a moment, everybody.
We're a community bank. That's why we always try to approach things from a community-minded point of view. When something is in the best interest of the communities we serve, it's good for us as well. We're community-minded, just like you. Carolina Trust Bank, member FDIC. Community-minded, just like you.
We're community-minded, just like you.
Carolina Trust Bank, with three offices in Lincolnton, also in Gastonia, Denver, Forest City, Hickory, Lake Lure, and Vail. Member FDIC, an equal housing lender.
All right, Smoke, the D absolutely getting a Lincolnton fits right now.
Lincolnton just trying to force the ball to Sage, and North Surry's been prepared for this. They know he's the main playmaker, and they're going back into their four-court press coming out of the timeout.
22-7, Greyhounds on top, 3:04 to go, first quarter play. Cowie gets it inbounds quickly. Here's Sage Surratt. Surratt crosses the line at midcourt. He'll take it, lay it up, hanging shot, no good, hit nothing, go back up and makes it. Reverse layup, draws a foul. 22-9, he'll shoot a free throw.
Yeah, and they needed to get a basket there, much needed basket for the Lincolnton Wolves, and now they might get a three-point play here.
2 minutes and 54 seconds to go, first quarter of play, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard, Surratt on the line, free throw up and good, connects with a three-point play the old-fashioned way, 22-10. Wolves still down by 12.
He's got to get some defense. They're allowing North Surry to get into the lane too easily. Chris Robinson got to step it up here.
Mason Hawks had an outstanding so far tonight with this ball game. In some trouble was Phillips. Gives it back to Mason Hawks. Hawks between the leg pass, kick back out up top to Phillips. Phillips will drive, stop, up, off the glass, good.
Beautiful footwork there by Phillips on Skylar Evans.
24-10, 14-point Greyhound lead, 2 minutes and 23 seconds in the first quarter of play. Double team, Sage in some trouble, got to get rid of it, can't get rid of it, watch out, almost 5-second call. Here's Cowie with the basketball, he loses it in the corner. What's going on here now?
A foul number 14, I believe, for North Surry.
So. Yep, sure was. That foul is on Chase Chandler.
Now Now Tyshawn Harris checking in for Young Sherrill. Looks like Lincoln's just trying to go a little small ball here. Young's at a disadvantage with all these small players on North Surry.
2 minutes and 12 seconds to go. First quarter play, 24-10. North Surry on top of Lincolnton. Shocking the Wolves right now. Inbounds, it goes to Sage. Sage in the lane. Hanging shot off the glass. No good. Fought for his own rebound on the floor. Harris scrambling for the loose ball. Jump ball possession belongs to the Wolves.
And that was yet another inbounds pass that got very close, if not right at 5 seconds, but no call there.
2 minutes and 4 seconds to go. First quarter play, 24-10. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Greyhounds on top.
Now Sage is inbounding the pass. Gets it out a lot quicker.
Inbounds to Cowie. Back to Sage. Baseline shot partially blocked. Goes back up. Misses his second try. Rebound Mason Hawks. Hawks on the run. Kicks it out. Thought about a three. Penetrate. Kendall Tucker missed it. Drew a foul. He'll shoot two.
I think that's Chris Robinson's second foul. So not only are you down 14 right now, but one of your main playmakers has got in foul trouble early on.
Team's a little bit better this deep in the playoffs, Smoke.
Oh, yeah, most certainly. And when you got a team that has nine seniors, they're battle-tested and ready for a matchup like this. And they're showing it right now.
This is Kendall Tucker on the free throw line. Shot up and good. 25-10, 15-point advantage right now for North Surry over Lincolnton.
Kendall Tucker now has 11 points in this first quarter. So Young Sherrill checks in for the Chris Robinson, who is in foul trouble. But Sage has scored all but 2 points for the Wolves early on.
Second try for Kendall Tucker. It's on the way. It is good. 26-10. 16-point advantage now for the Greyhounds.
Now Casey Hull checks back in, giving a much-deserved rest for Kendall Tucker.
Cowie inbounds to Harris. Over to Sage. Sage double team to Cowie. Cowie to Tyshawn Harris. He'll drive up. Good. Nice strong move by Tyshawn Harris between two defenders to make it 26-12 with 95 seconds in the period.
Showing once again he's got some big hops for a small guy.
Under 90 seconds now in the quarter. Mason Hawks goes over to Phillips. Inside to Hawks. Layup good. Backdoor play. Makes it 28-12. 1:18 to go in the first quarter of play. Sage Surratt bumps off a defender. Give it up inside to Young Sherrill. He'll be caught on the charge. Nothing going Lincoln's way right now.
No, nothing at all.
69 seconds in the quarter, 28-12. North Surry on top of Lincolnton, shocking this crowd here on a Saturday night.
Yeah, it's completely. Well, Lincolnton is completely quiet right now on the other side. They're going to have to get a spark sooner, or this game might be over before the end of the first half if they're not careful.
You ain't kidding. Here is Mason Hawks. Takes a three, missed it. Rebound Young Sherrill off to Sage Surratt. Surratt running the forecourt of the dribble. Lob it inside to Cowie. Cowie three, right side, no good. Rebound comes down to Jacob Harrison, who's in the game now for the Greyhounds. 42 seconds in the quarter, 28-12. North Surry's on top of the Wolves. Here's Carter posting up out in the corner. Now on the wing. Up top it goes to Hawks. Hawks will drive the lane, kick it out in the corner, back outside, now back in, off the glass, good. Look at the way they move that ball. Casey Hull makes it 30-12 with 20 seconds in the quarter. Great ball movement right there by the Greyhounds. Here's Sage Surratt. He'll take it. Underhand layup, no good. Rebound comes out of the Hounds. 10 seconds to go in the quarter. Here is Phillips. He'll take it, give it up to Hull, up and good. 32-12, 2 seconds, 1 second at the buzzer. Missed the shot and we played one here. A 20-point North Surry lead. Back in a moment, high school basketball on 1050 AM. KDCBroadcasting.com and the Ustream app. Back in a moment, everybody.
Sooner or later, everyone wants to make their home dreams a reality. And Key Builders in Lincolnton is here to help make your home dreams come true. Visit their website at keybuildersnc.com and visit their gallery of homes and floor plans. Or they will build from your dream home floor plan too. They'll be there to help you with every step of the way. So for your dream home, visit Key Builders in Lincolnton,
1459 North Aspen Street in Lincolnton, or again online at keybuildersnc.com.
Well, Smoke, 25-1 this season. Great year. Down by 20 points after one quarter play to a North Surry team that's making everything happen for them tonight right now.
You know, I don't really know why Lincolnton's playing this bad. Just North Surry has been incredible. You know, Lincolnton's going to have to wake up here if they want to win this game, Derek. There's no questions about it. And they got to have someone other than Sage get scoring, because that's all that's happening right now.
All right. They've got the basketball to begin the quarter two, which is even worse if you're a Lincolnton fan right now. Everything going their way. Well-executed team. Outstanding so far. Ryan Ward is coming to game. They are deep. Here's Mason Hawks. Thought about a three. Didn't take it. Backs back up. Dribbles between the legs against Robinson inside the lane. Stop. Up. Good. 34-12. 7:34 to go in the first half of play. Sage Surratt's going to take this team on his shoulders. Here's a Cowie shot, though. It's good. Cowie makes it 34-15. Going to need a lot of those the rest of the night out. Here's Mason Hawks. Thought about a three on the wing, near side wing. Cross-court pass to Phillips. Three. Good. Oh, my. They can't miss anything right now. 37-15. 7:09 to go in the first
Sage
half of play.
Just gave him way too much room there, and Carter Phillips is confident in his shot.
Here's Surratt. He'll take it underhand to Givens. Good. Givens baseline. Hanging shot. 37-17, but you're still down by 20 points.
Going to have to get some stops on defense. They haven't been able to do that all night.
6:50 to go. Second quarter of play. They'll slow it down a little bit. Near side wing, it goes to Harrison, who's in there. Back up top. Harrison gets it. He'll shoot a three. He makes a three-point shot off the bench. Man alive, 40-17.
He's giving them way too much room.
Cowie in the corner. Three. Good. Cowie comes back with a three-point shot, but you're still down by 20, 40-20.
And you're trading shots too, Derek.
Not going to work. Not going to work. Got to make some stops. Here's Phillips inside the hole off the glass. He drew a foul on young Sherrill.
Now that's two fouls on another starter for Lincolnton.
Fouls on number 34, Sherrill. That's his first.
6 minutes and 12 seconds in the first half of play. 40 for the Greyhounds, 20 for the Wolves. Casey Hall's free throw, good. 41-20.
Now we have checking into the game Kendall Tucker and Chase Chandler for the Greyhounds.
9-10 deep, it looks like.
Well, they got nine seniors.
Second shot by Hall is up and good. 42-20. 22-point North Surry advantage here in the first half of play. Here's Sage Surratt. Double teamed. In some trouble. Can't get rid of the basketball. Finally does to young Sherrill. He'll take it. Layup underhand. Good. Big hook shot. Scooping shot for young Sherrill. 42-22, but you're still down by 20.
Mm-hmm. Got to get a stop here. Can't say it enough.
5:51 to go in the half. Over in the corner. Now here's a three. In and out. No good. Missed by Carter Phillips. Rebound comes down to Lincolnton. Sage Surratt runs the point. Takes it up off the glass. Good. 42-24 to within 18. 5 minutes and 25 seconds and a half. Here's Mason Hawks. Bounce pass to Phillips. No foul called. Fans wanted it. Sure did. Phillips in the lane. Spins. Whistle. Foul on the floor or shooting foul?
Think that.
Sherrill with the foul.
Sherrill. That's
shooting
third foul.
Yep.
Shooting two is number four, Phillips.
Must be the Under Armour uniforms. Free throw, good. 43-24. North Surry on top with 5:17 to go in the half. They've come and played like it's their home floor. Here's a shot up and good, makes a pair. 44-24, back up by 20 are the Hounds. Inbounds to Surratt. Surratt takes it, gives it up to Skylar Evans. Missed the easy layup off the glass, too strong. Mason Hawks in the forecourt. He'll penetrate the lane. Hanging shot and out. No good. Rebound stolen on the hands. Chris Robinson's got it. Robinson loses the basketball. Carter Phillips comes away. Gives it to Mason Hawks on the right side. Inside to Phillips. Phillips up against Robinson. Spins off the glass. Good.
Yeah, I don't get why Sage didn't try to go for that ball there because Hawks could not find it.
46-24. North Surry on top, still big. 4 minutes and 39 seconds in the half.
Coach Kevin King doing a tremendous job coaching this Hawks team. As I think Sage just got away from push off there.
Three, but he made a three on the far side near the front row. In front of his brother over there, who's come down from Chapel Hill.
Yeah.
46-27, 4 minutes and 22 seconds in the half.
Try to get it to 15 at least before halftime here if you're the Wolves. Got to start playing some defense, not allowing these shots to go in.
Come over in the corner, back up top. Now around this side, near side wing to Hawks. Back it up, slow it down. Try to drive against Robinson, behind the back, dribble and through the lane, and man, he made him look bad right there. 48-27.
Hawks has got some amazing ball handling skills there.
3 minutes and 50 seconds. Here comes Sage. He'll take it. Get it stripped on the floor. Picked up. Gets it back off the glass. In. 48-29. 3 minutes and 40 seconds. First half of play. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. 3 minutes and 30 seconds now. Here's Mason Hawks. Three. Good. Oh, my goodness. They making everything tonight.
They're giving Lincolnton a taste of their own medicine to where they
can
miss. It's
incredible. Wow, wow. 3 minutes and 15 seconds in the half. 51-29. 50 points so far in the half. Inside to Harris. Back up top to Robinson. Robinson, three. No good. Tap, no good. Gibbons up a second time and makes it. 51-31, but you're still down by 20 points with 2 minutes and 55 seconds in the half. Holy mackerel. Stunning the Wolves right now. Here's Mason Hawks. He's a heck of a ball handler. Chase Chandler cross side. Here we go. Shot up by Kendall Tucker. Missed it. Rebound Cowie. Cowie goes to Sage Surratt. Surratt in the forecourt of the dribble against Chandler. Spins. Post up. Falls away. No good. Rebound comes down the hands of Casey Hall with 2 minutes and 25 seconds in the half. 51-31, Greyhounds on top. Hounds will slow it down now. Carter Phillips with the basketball. Bounce pass to Mason Hawks near the scorer's table. Inside to Phillips. Phillips between Cowley off the glass, too strong. Rebound, Hall got fouled by Skylar Evans, and there'll be a two-shot foul at the line.
Can't allow those rebounds. Didn't even try to box out there, did Evans. Got to box him out here. Every missed shot is an opportunity for you guys to get the rebound and drive the ball down the court and try to shrink this lead as much as you can.
2:02 and a half, 51-31, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Free throw, hole, good, nothing but net.
Make things worse for Lincolnton. North Surry's making pretty much all of their free throws so far.
52-31. Second shot coming. It is no good. Got a break there. Cowie with the board. 2 minutes to go in the half. Give it out to Robinson. Robinson, near side wing. Take it in the lane. Lose the basketball. Picked up once again by the Greyhounds in the corner. Jump ball. Possession who?
I think it's going to go in favor of Lincolnton. As we got to Bobby Cowley and Simmons both on the baseline.
Yeah. Both teams claims they have it, but it's going to belong to Lincolnton with 1 minute and 51 seconds to go. First half of play, 52-31. North Surry on top of this third round matchup into Robinson. Robinson takes it up top on the dribble. Near side wing in the lane, stop, gets it blocked. Rebound comes down to Avery Smith who's come in the game. They'll push it ahead. Stolen away by Young Sherrill. Gives it up to Surratt. Surratt loses the basketball. Picked up by Tyshawn Harris, who's fouled with 1:36 in the half. Not a shooting foul. Coward inbound beneath the basket.
Next foul will be a bonus for either team. Both teams are at six fouls.
Inbounds near the Greyhound bench.
Hey, you're finally starting to get stops here, Lincolnton, but you got to get the shots going now.
Here's Chris Robinson to Tyshawn Harris in the lane. Wow, what a shot by Tyshawn Harris. Underhanded, flying through the lane. 52-33, 1:25 to go in the half. Carter Phillips slows it down, top of the key. Come over this side to Tucker. Tucker, three, good. Man alive, cannot miss anything today.
That was Lincolnton's fault there because they were so focused on Phillips and taking a while to get there.
55-33, 65 seconds in the half. Surratt thought about a three, didn't take it. Cowie thought about a three. Robinson will take it now behind the arc, leave it short. Rebound comes down to Simmons. 53 seconds in the half. 55-33, Greyhounds on top. Slowing it down is Mason Hawks. He's had a heck of a half.
Probably trying to get the last shot here.
Down to 40 seconds. 35 seconds. Hawks still up top on the dribble near midcourt. Robinson coming up to meet him. Down to 25 seconds. He ain't going nowhere, Smoke.
No, and he's in the corner. He's taking his time. As now Chris Robinson's trying to creep closer and closer. Now he's making moves.
He'll drive, come out this side, get it back up top, slow it back down 15 seconds.
Beautiful.
14 seconds, 13 seconds, 12 seconds. Crowd up on their feet. 9 seconds. Hawks, he'll take it. Kick it out. Three, Tucker, no good. Surratt with the board. 4 seconds, 3 seconds. Shot at midcourt. It is no good. And we have played one half here at Lincolnton. It is North Surry 55, Lincolnton 33. Back in a moment for the Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge halftime show. Back in a moment, everybody.
We make a joyful noise cheering our favorite high school football teams on Friday nights and our favorite college teams on Saturday. The family of faith at Ryan Heights United Methodist Church would like to invite you to come and make a joyful noise for the Lord on Sundays. Sunday school is at 10 and worship is at 11. Ryan Heights United Methodist Church is in Lincolnton on Madison Street, just up from Betty Ross Park. Come make a joyful noise with us.
When you need a ride, Specialized Transport has exactly what you're looking for, serving Gaston, Lincoln, Catawba, Burke, Caldwell, and Cleveland counties. Specialized Transport has your area covered. Ambulatory, wheelchair, and geriatric chair transport, handicap transportation services, and non-medical transport services are available as well. When you need a ride, call Dean Hastings at 704-735-5676. Specialized Transport will get you where you need to be. 704-735-5676.
For over 100 years, the Stamey Tysinger Funeral Home in Falston has been providing services to families of our community with care and compassion. And now the Stamey Funeral Home has added the Cremation Center along with a new name, the Stamey Tysinger Funeral Home and Cremation Center. The Stamey Tysinger Funeral Home and Cremation Center on Highway 182 in Falston and the Stamey Funeral Home in Cherryville, located on Dixie Street in Cherryville, serving you with care and compassion in your time of need.
Within sight, roll in to CarQuest and roll on.
Be sure to visit Eddie's Auto Park, 2514 East Main Street in Lincolnton, your local CarQuest distributor.
When you want some help from a fellow car lover, it's all in one place, as you'll discover. Roll in to CarQuest and roll on.
Turner Hauser Insurance Group has moved into the new location at 228 East Main Street in downtown Lincolnton, and you're invited to come by
Jamie Hauser can help you with your home, auto, commercial, farm, or life insurance needs. Turner Hauser Insurance Group is here to serve their community and help you protect what matters. Visit the new location, Turner Hauser Insurance Group, 228 East Main Street in downtown Lincolnton. Just look for the big blue awning. Online at turnerhauserins.com. Call 704-732-9577.
All right, welcome back here to Lincolnton High School. This is a Renato Audemars broadcast of Lincoln County basketball here on 1050 WLON AM and on KTCBroadcasting.com. I'm Evan Ludwig here for the Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge halftime report. Remember, Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge is on 1442 East Main Street in Lincolnton. Call 1-800-1877-262-0514 or 704-732-1890. Also, you can go to AbernathyChryslerJeepDodge.com for more details on some of the cars that they have on sale. Here at halftime, it's a shocker for Lincolnton, who is just being dominated here in this first half. I'm somewhat at a loss for words at how Lincolnton has been dominated in this first half. 55-33 on the First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. North Surry has come to play. They brought a great crowd here tonight. And first, let's go over the stats. We'll talk about that Greyhound team right now. Mason Hawks, after one half of play, has 10 points, 5 assists, and 2 rebounds. Carter Phillips, their leading scorer heading into this game, is the leading scorer so far with 18 points, 3 assists, and 1 rebound. And also, Kendall Tucker has been having a great game, more than his average. He has 15 points, 1 assist, 1 rebound. Casey Hall been doing a pretty good job. 3 rebounds, 2 assists, and 7 points. Chase Chandler coming off the bench with 1 assist and a 1 rebound for Avery Smith. 2 points and 1 rebound and assist for Ethan Simmons. And a 3-point basket made by Jacob Harrison along with a rebound. Quite the chart for North Surry in the first half, who has not missed hardly any shots so far. Now go over to Lincolnton. It's the other side of the spectrum. Take a complete 180, basically, as now North Surry did not spend that much time in the locker room. They're coming out with over 5 minutes remaining in half. So Tyshawn Harris doing a good job off the bench, 4 points and 1 rebound. They have Chris Robinson extremely quiet and also in foul trouble with 2 rebounds and 1 assist. And scoreless. Sage Surratt is doing his usual thing, 15 points, 5 assists, and 3 rebounds, but you got to have more than that to get back in this ball game here. Robbie Cowley, only 6 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists. Young Cheryl, quiet night for him, 2 rebounds, 2 points. And Langdon Givens having a better night scoring than he has in recent memory with 6 points and 1 rebound. As to foul trouble for the Wolves, Chris Robinson with 2 fouls and Young Cheryl with 3 fouls. So the big man is in trouble heading into the second half of play here at Lincolnton High School. Looking at the foul trouble for North Surry, every player that has a foul in North Surry has only 1 foul. So they have no concerns right now heading into the start of the second half. We'll come back for a little bit more to end the Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge halftime show. And remember, we're starting the second half in a little over 4 minutes. Be right back here on WLON 1050 AM and on KTCBroadcasting.com.
When Auto Owners Insurance was founded in 1916, the world was quite different. Yet with all that's changed, our commitment to be there when you need us most hasn't. By teaming up with independent agents, we've made a difference for generations of customers and will for generations to come. And by making a difference every day, 100 years seem to go by in a flash.
Your local Auto Owners Insurance Agency is Mooney Insurance Agency, located at 528 East Main Street in Maiden. Call 828-428-8231. It's the best deal of the year right now at Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC in Lincolnton. Save big during Abernathy's pre-owned inventory blowout sale. They all gotta go. Check out the great deals on cars, trucks, SUVs, and vans. Save thousands of dollars. Find out why more people buy again and again from Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC in Lincolnton. Come experience the Abernathy Advantage today at Abernathy's Chevrolet Buick GMC, 1445 East Main Street in Lincolnton, online at AbernathyChevrolet.com. The Start Something New sales event is underway at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge in Lincolnton.
Find out how you can get $3,000 total cash or 0% financing for 60 months and $2,500 bonus cash on the new 2016 Dodge Charger. Don't miss it. The Start Something New sales event. Going on now at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge, 1442 East Main Street in Lincolnton. It's time to start something new at Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge in Lincolnton.
The voice of Woody Durham calling the Hills games brought bright smiles to the faces of Tar Heel fans everywhere. Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton will brighten your smiles with professional cosmetic dentistry and smile enhancement procedures for everyone. Even Duke fans will smile at the work of this Tar Heel. The office of Dr. John L. Cloninger III is located at 904 Doncha Drive. For an appointment, call 704-735-0765. That's 704-735-0765. And John III says best wishes to all high school athletes.
It's the Subway Sub of the Day. Each day of the week, you get a different 6-inch sub for just $3.50. Monday, the Sweet Onion Chicken Teriyaki Sub. Tuesday, the Oven Roasted Chicken Sub. Wednesday, the Turkey Breast Sub. Thursday, the Italian BMT Sub. Friday, the Tuna Sub. Saturday, the Black Forest Ham Sub. And Sunday, the Meatball Marinara Sub. Your choice, just $3.50. The Sub of the Day from Subway in Boger City and the Walmart in Lincolnton. You don't pull a mask
off at all. Right, back here at Lincolnton High School, about ready to start the second half here. Evan Ludwig and Derek Smith with you here. This is a Renata Ottawa broadcast of Lincoln County Basketball on WLON 1050 AM as we want to thank Abernathy Chrysler Jeep Dodge for the halftime show. And now Derek joins back with us. Derek? What do you think of this first half so far?
Well, crowd outside in the lobby, obviously stunned at what they're seeing. They're just not believing that this team has come in and shot the high percentage that they have from all over the floor. And really the defense, the pressure they put on Lincolnton has been unbelievable.
Yeah, quite impressive as getting a standing ovation here from the North Surry crowd as their team comes back out. And to make things worse, North Surry's getting the inbounds pass to start the second half.
Hmm. So 55-33, Greyhounds on top, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. This is a third round matchup in the Class 2A bracket of the High School Association State Playoffs. Greyhounds moving left to right now on your dial. Mason Hawks, a heck of a first half. Inside to Simmons, back to Hawks, back up top to Phillips. Cross court it goes to Tucker. Back up top to Hawks now. They can afford to slow things down, I would think. Inside the lane, kick it out to Simmons. Simmons cross-court pass, it goes to Phillips, but have a whistle and it'll be Lincolnton basketball.
And that's what Lincolnton needs, just any way possible that they can't get a point on any of the possessions from now on. They gotta just short the gap slowly, gnaw at it.
All right, Wolves moving right to left on your dial. Here is Cowie. Cowie going to take it. Give it up to Robinson, near side wing. Back up top to Sage. Three, Surratt, good. There's a start. 55-36, you're down by 19. Just underway, second half of play. Got to get a stop here. That's Phillips, good.
Phillips kind of used, I believe that was Robinson, as a pick on Surratt.
57-36, 7:02 to go in the third period of play. Here's Surratt. He'll take it. Off the glass. Miss it. Rebound Simmons. Out to Hawks. Hawks cross court. Tucker. Baseline. Layup. Good. 59-36, 6:45 to go. Third quarter of play. Cowie to Robinson. Three. Robinson no good. Rebound. Out to Simmons. To Hawks. To Casey Hall. Casey Hall misses the shot. Rebound, Chris Robinson. Robinson takes it. Gets it knocked away. Turnover. Greyhound basketball. Give it to Phillips. Off the glass. Good. Blocking call called on Chris.
No,
charge.
I think that might be a charge. No, basket's good.
Blocking call on Chris Robinson. That was my initial thought.
It looked like it. I guess his and one looked a lot like a charge call there.
61-36, 6 minutes and 21 seconds in the third quarter of play.
Now Tyshawn Harris checking in for Chris Robinson, who has three fouls. Young Cheryl also has three fouls as well, so look out for that one. But things are getting out of hand to start the second half.
Robinson's a shooter, too. You don't need him on the bench.
No, you don't.
Free throw, Phillips, good. 62-36, 6:20 to go, third quarter play. It's been all Greyhounds tonight. Here's Tyshawn Harris. He'll get it stripped away.
Wow, right there, Kendall Tucker just ripped it out of Tyshawn Harris's hand. A clean takeaway there.
Carter Phillips into Simmons. Simmons to Hawks. Hawks will drive, kick it out to Hall. Hawks baseline layup, get it blocked by Cowley. Cowley comes away with a loose ball. He'll take it. Stop. Behind the line, thought about a three, give it to Sage, who'll take a three, miss it short. Rebound Kendall Tucker, ahead to Hawks, layup blocked by Cowley. No foul. Here comes Sage with the ball, give it up to Gibbons. Gibbons baseline, missed the shot underneath the basket. Rebound fought for, who's got it? Cowley missed the shot. Rebound Sage off the glass, draws a foul, he'll shoot two. North Surry fans not liking what they're seeing right now. Surry out of the free throw line with a 62-36 deficit for his ball club. Free throw, no good.
And you can't have missed free throws if you're Lincolnton. Every point matters right now. The margin for error is small as can be.
5 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the third quarter of play. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. All Greyhounds all night. Surratt free throw, good. 62-37. 5:29 to go, third quarter of play. Give it up to Carter Phillips. Carter Phillips, get it out to Hawks in the corner. Tucker, back to Hawks. Back to Phillips. Phillips, top of the key, loses the basketball, picks it back up, gives it to Hawks. Hawks, back to Phillips. Phillips, inside, back to Hawks. Work it around to Simmons. Simmons inside, good.
Beautiful ball movement.
Unbelievable. They call a timeout. We'll break as well. Back in a moment. High school basketball at 10:50 a.m. KBCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app on your mobile device.
Ranger and your dome mills around with Jim.
Drew, this new city just makes me miss home, man. Go get a sweet tea from McDonald's. They make it fresh, sweet, and it's icy cold, just like your mom's. But I miss home. Oh, so you miss your mom telling you to make sure your room's clean? Or
close the fridge, Ryan, and stop letting all the cool air out. Or turn them lights off,
Ryan. All right, got it. The sweet tea is just right. But you know I'm going to tell my mom you got jokes.
No, don't.
This is no joke. Stop by McDonald's and get a large sweet tea for just $1 all summer long. Large sweet tea, just $1. Price and participation may vary. Limited time only.
In my mind, I'm gone.
5 minutes and 4 seconds, third quarter play. North Surry 64, Lincolnton 37. Greyhounds call a timeout. Lincolnton basketball, backcourt pressure now by the Greyhounds. Cowley to Surratt. Back to Cowley. Cowley, forecourt on the dribble. Near side wing with it. Baseline in the corner, give it up to Harris. Harris up top to Surratt. Surratt will take it in the lane. Underhanded pass to Cheryl off the glass. Good, young Cheryl. 64-39. Back down the floor come the Greyhounds. There's Carter Phillips to Hall. Good. 66-39. Midway through third quarter of play. Sage thought about a three. Now Cowley will take the trifecta. No good. Rebound Carter Phillips.
And now North Surry knows, hey, we can take our time here a little bit. We're almost up by 30.
Mason Hawks near the midcourt circle. Bounce pass to Phillips. Phillips, Sage stuck a hand in. He'll pick up a personal foul, not a shooting foul, though.
And this North Surry crowd has wanted a lot of fouls on Sage, and I think I agree with him somewhat. He has gotten away with a good bit of foul calls tonight, but he finally gets on the foul board here. That's only his first, though.
4:12 to go in the third. Inbounds. Checking in now is Avery Smith, who's come back in. They're very deep. Also, Kendall Tucker's back in there. He'll give it to Hawks. Three, no good. Rebound, young Cheryl. Give it up to Surratt. Surratt will take it, lay it up, finger roll, no good. Draw foul, he'll shoot two.
Foul's going to be on
Phillips.
Carter Phillips. That's his first foul. So both leading scorers have now gotten one foul as Sage Rats at the 80s Auto Parts free throw line.
3 minutes and 54 seconds. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard, 66-39. Sage misses the first of his two free throws.
Skylar Evans coming in for Langdon Givens.
Second shot is up and good. Makes one of two. Down by 26, 66-40. 3:52. Inbounds pass knocked away. Still will belong to the Greyhounds.
I like to see that from Tyshawn Harris. Even though it's a 26-point deficit right now, he's still giving it his all, and he's coming off the bench.
Mason Hawks with it. Gives it up to Phillips. Phillips will take it. Give it in the corner. Back to Chandler. Back to Phillips. Back to Hawks. In the corner, Chandler back to Hawks. Hawks playing up near the midcourt circle. Comes over on the right wing, gets it back to Phillips. Phillips will drive the lane, give it up. Underhanded reverse layup, missed, no good by Smith. Rebound Sage Surratt. 3-on-2 break. Sage in the lane, draws a foul. Blocking foul will be called on, I believe that is Mason Hawks.
I think you can hear on the background, more Surry fans not happy about that call.
They seem to think Sage getting the benefit of the doubt, Smoke.
Oh, let's see if he can take advantage of this foul call here. He's missed two free throws right now.
I mean, you got a 26-point lead. I mean, really?
Then again, they might have heard about the last-minute comeback from Lincolnton a couple week ago. So.
You got a 26-point lead. Free throw, good, made two, 24-point lead. 66-42, 3:22 to go, third quarter play. A very impressive Greyhound bunch in here tonight against this Lincolnton team that lost one time this year to West Caldwell back in January. Now the Wolves will come up with some pressure in the backcourt. Cowie against Hawks. Hawks underneath, bounce pass good to Carter Phillips, made it look easy once again. 68-24, 3:07 to go, third quarter of play. Chris Robinson's back in there with three fouls, and he will walk with a basketball.
Yeah, that's the last thing you need if you're Lincolnton to get a turnover down, heck, almost 26 points with 3 minutes to go in the third quarter.
68-42, under three to go in the third. Surratt is out. He's set to check back in. Here's Carter Phillips. Shot right side lane. Good. Making everything they throw up there tonight, Smoke.
They had to at least make about 60% of their shots.
70-42. Robinson in the lane. Off the glass. Rolls around up and good. And there will be a timeout called by Cowie. We'll step aside as well. High school basketball at 10:50 a.m. KDCBroadcasting.com. The Ustream app on your mobile device. Back in a moment.
The Orange Opportunity Sales Event is underway at Parker Farm Service in Kings Mountain. Come in now and ask about 0% financing for 84 months on select Kubota tractors with a big 6-year warranty. So come in for all the details. Also, pick up this week's What's Up Shopper for the spring service coupons. Save from $10 to $200 off with your coupon. Just pick up this week's What's Up Shopper at Parker Farm Service, located at 126 Bessie Drive off Oak Grove Road and a Highway 74 bypass in Kings Mountain.
Derek and Evan back with you. 70-44. Greyhounds on top of the Wolves. 2:35 to go in the third. Greyhound basketball walking call on Avery Smith beneath the basket. Lincolnton will get the hoop now. 2:32. Whistle, what's going on here?
We had a late check-in. Casey Hall now checking into the game. He's had himself quite a night. Let's see, 11 points as he's one of the starters and 3 rebounds, 2 assists.
Surratt's going to take it coast-to-coast possibly, and there will be a charging call on Surratt. Are you kidding me?
I don't know about that one there. It just looked like they've been letting a lot of contact go in tonight's game. And on these fast breaks, that's one of the lighter ones, so I don't know about that one, Derek, but they call it a foul nonetheless.
70-44, 2:25 to go in the third. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Mason Hawks has got it. Impressive point guard. Distributes the basketball well and shoot two.
And he got some nice handles too, Derek.
Mm-hmm. He'll take it. Underhanded draw foul. 209, 70 to 44.
And another foul on Chris Robinson. That's now his fourth. So Chris Robinson only one foul away from fouling out as Hawks is going to the Eddie's Auto Parts free throw line.
209. No, missed it. Wow.
That's probably the first mistake he's made all night.
Sure is. Second try for Mason Hawks. Up. Good. 71-44, 209, third quarter play. Sade Surratt with the basketball to Robbie Cowie. They'll get Mason Hawks on the foul of Cowie. Top of the key. Not a shooting foul. Stops the clock at 202. Cowie to inbound in front of his dad.
That's Hawks' third foul, so now North Surry has one guy in foul trouble.
Sage Surratt thought about a three. He'll drive the lane, back post up, off the glass strong. He's so strong with that move. You almost can't stop it, Smoke. 71-46, a minute 47 to go. Back down is Casey Hall, caught on the charge.
Now that's Hall's third foul. Benefit here is now North Surry has five fouls late in the third quarter. They could get, Lincolnton could get the bonus here in early parts of the fourth quarter.
Underhanded pass, missed the easy shot, did Givens. Rebound, Mason Hawks, 102, one on two, underhanded, no good. Tapped around, Cowie's got it.
Nice job.
Saves it off the body of Carla Phillips. It'll be Lincolnton basketball.
Nice awareness there by Cowie to hit it off the leg of one of the North Surry defenders.
Inside he goes to Sage Surratt, inbound play. Sage in the fourth quarter on the dribble. Three, top of the key, no good, left it short, rebound Phillips. Out to Carter, Carter slows it down, gives it up to Carter Phillips. Phillips in the lane, foul line shot, good. 73-46, 69 seconds in the period. Give it up to Givens, to Cowie, out to Robinson. Robinson drives, underhanded pass, and nobody is there.
Yeah, he thought Cowie was going to stay there on the baseline, but he went out to the three-point line, caused another turnover.
63 seconds in the half, 73-46, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. All Greyhound since the get-go. Ran out to a double-digit lead within seconds of this contest getting underway. Mason Hawks underneath to Hall off the glass, good.
And that's when you know things are going right. Hall lost control of that ball, and he's still able to get the shot in.
Here's Cowie out to Givens. Givens not a shooter, not going to take the shot. Inside to Sage. Sage double team, in some trouble. Cross court to Cowie, three, no good. Rebound tapped around and into the hands of Mason Hawks, and a backcourt foul on Tayshawn Harris. Stops the clock at 26 seconds in the third quarter of play. Score 75-46, Greyhounds. They've got the basketball. Slowing it down, Phillips into forecourt. Met by Surratt. Surratt sticks the hand in. Kick it out to, that was Chandler who's in back in the game. Carter Phillips backs it up near midcourt, down to 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Phillips stop, up to Hawk. Hawk thought about a three. He'll drive out to Phillips, three at the buzzer, good. Wow, unbelievable. Shot at the buzzer makes it a 78-46 Greyhound lead back to the fourth quarter after we break. High school basketball, 10:50 a.m., KDCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app. Back in a moment.
The lowest prices on quality automobiles just got lower at Milholland Automotive in Lincolnton.
Mill Holland Automotive in Lincoln is having a year-end clearance sale. Prices have been slashed on every unit in stock. Save thousands of dollars on your next vehicle. At Mill Holland Automotive in Lincoln, you get 1.9% financing with approved credit. And they are the king of zero money down. Plus a warranty on every vehicle. Mill Holland Automotive, 423 West Main Street in Lincoln, online at millhollandautomotive.com.
Carpenter, what do you know? Our buddy Lewis Carpenter in the house tonight. Good to see old Lewis here this evening, former KDCBroadcasting.com post-game studio host.
Yeah, he even still calls in sometimes.
Sure does.
Yeah.
Well, Smug, 78-46, 8 minutes left. You know, it's probably impossible, you would think.
Yeah, it's just no momentum going for Lincolnton right now. You got one of your big playmakers in foul trouble. I don't see this happening. It looks like it's going to come to a very disappointing end here for Lincolnton.
All right, Robinson with the basketball. Cowie's got it inside to Sage. Sage loses it. Cowie gets it back. Baseline shot, no good. Givens with the board, saves it into Surratt. Surratt loses it out of bounds off his hands, belonging to the Greyhounds.
Hey, when it's your night, it's your night.
All right, here comes Mason Hawks in the forecourt. Top of the key to Carter Phillips. That's a 1-2 combination that's been deadly tonight.
Yes, it has.
Watch out down the road, whoever they face. Chandler to Phillips. Three, no good. Rebound Robinson. Robinson ahead to Givens. Layup, good. Givens, 78-48. Down by 30, though. 7:12 to go in the ballgame. Carter Phillips against Surratt. He'll take it. Fall away, hanging shot, no good. Air ball. Rebound underneath was Casey Hall. He draws a foul. He'll shoot two.
Let's see who the foul's on here. It's on Cowie. Cowie's first time being called for a foul as Kendall Tucker takes a trip to the Eddie's Auto Parts free throw line.
Well, you know it's a big game when Lewis Carpenter's here.
Yes. Surprised we didn't see him here Thursday.
Free throw up and good. Kendall Tucker makes it 79-48 with exactly 7 minutes left in the ballgame and potentially the season for the Lincolnton Wolves. You never say never, but man alive. Up and good. 78-80-48 now. Here comes Cowie. Cowie. Hanging shot right side. Good. 80-50. 6:46 left in this one. Mason Hawks on the dribble. Top of the key. Bounce pass to Phillips underneath. Good chase, Chandler. He was wide open. Nobody behind him. 82-50. Very fundamental, aren't they?
Yes, extremely fundamental.
Robinson's got it. Hanging shot, layup, good. 82-52, 6:19 to go in the ballgame. Mason Hawks inside, spins around to Casey Hall, and he makes the basket, 84-52. Here's Robinson. His pass is knocked away, intended for Givens, out of bounds. It belonged to Lincolnton.
Skylar Evans checking in for Lincolnton, and Ethan Simmons checking back in for North
Chandler
Surry.
Chandler out. Cowie beneath his own basket to inbounds. 6:06 left in the contest. 84-52, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard, Greyhounds on top big. Here's Surratt in the lane, stop, underhand finger roll, good. 84-54, under six to go in the ballgame now. Mason Hawks back near midcourt. He'll take it, left wing, great dribbler, up top to Simmons with the great looking haircut. Best haircut of the season, no doubt about it. Here is Hawks. Hawks inside, loses it, picked up by Givens. Away to Surratt, 5:32 to go in a ballgame. Surratt, take it, coast to coast, finger roll, good Surratt. 84-56, 5:25 to go in the night.
Yeah, North Surry just slowly taking it down the court.
Carter Phillips loses it, picked up by Robinson. Robinson, 1-0-2 break, give it up, and
Skylar Evans can't take the handle on the pass. It's out of bounds. It'll be Greyhound basketball.
That's been the game in a nutshell for Lincolnton. Just can't get anything going. They're causing turnovers. This North Surry defense got back to not have the fast break there for Lincolnton, and it caused a freak pass for Chris Robinson, and Skylar Evans wasn't ready.
84-56, 5:05 to go. Fourth quarter of play, First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. Carter Phillips, bounce pass in the corner. That is Kendall Tucker back in there. Kendall Tucker drives the lane. Shot is partially blocked. Comes away with it. Skylar Evans to Cowie to Surratt. Surratt up underneath to Gibbons. Layup good off the glass. He's fouled. He'll shoot a free throw shot now.
Gibbons now in double figures. I haven't seen it in a while. As Avery Smith with his third foul.
4 minutes and 45 seconds, misses the free throw, can't connect on the three-point play. 84-54. Here's Carter Phillips, foul backcourt by Sage Surratt. Should be four, correct? Three?
Yeah, only three. Yep, three fouls on Sage Surratt. It's now, looks like North Surry is in the bonus as Carter Phillips is at the Eddie's Auto Parts free throw line.
Free throw, Phillips, good. 85-58, 4 minutes and 40 seconds left in the ballgame. Stay tuned, Marburger Chrysler Jeep Dodge postgame show is next. Up and no good, rebound tapped around for Surratt, saves it, but he steps out of bounds right in front of their bench. Greyhound basketball. Simmons to inbounds. Goes to Mason Hawks. Near the circle. Over to Avery Smith. Back up top to Simmons. Now to Carter Phillips. Carter Phillips will drive underneath to Avery Smith. Smith in some trouble. Back up top to Hawks. They'll slow it down. Start it all over again. Hawks will drive, spin, one-handed shot, no good, draws a foul, knocked down in the process. He'll shoot two from the charity stripe, though.
Yep, another foul on Cowie. That's now a second foul.
Kendall Tucker set to check back in.
Hawks, I mean, he has probably been the best pure point guard I've seen this year, Derek.
No doubt about it. Made it.
He's also got a double-double tonight.
86-58, 4 minutes and 14 seconds. Carter Phillips is out. Gets a standing ovation from the crowd, as he should.
Yeah, very well deserved. I believe Hawks will get one if he makes this free throw.
That's up and good.
Well, actually, no, he's not being checked in right now.
87-58, 4:12 to go in the ballgame. Sage loses it. Cowie gets it back to Robinson. Three, no good. Might have been partially blocked. Kendall Tucker with the board. Midcourt pass to Hawks. Hawks, far side wing. He will drive it. Cowie with the body on the foul. 1-1 coming in just a second.
I think really everything's starting to come. Everyone's starting to realize that North Surry's going to be advancing Tuesday. They're having more substitutions come in for the Greyhounds. Actually, this is weird. Carter Phillips checking back into the ballgame here.
Shelby or Lake Norman would have to go to North Surry on Tuesday night, should this margin of victory stay put. Good. 88-58, 30-point advantage with 3 minutes and 54 seconds in the fourth quarter of play. Second shot. Good.
Now we're starting to see some substitutions on Lincolnton. Now Mason Hawks getting a big standing ovation from the crowd, very well deserved as well. But checking in is Carter Phillips. Very rare do you see another starter checking for a starter in these situations.
Jeffrey Diaz is coming to game now. Robinson, top of the key, spins, gets it blocked. Hall away with the loose ball. Back to Carter Phillips. Carter Phillips spins, underhanded shot, foul, draws it.
I think that might be Robinson's fifth.
He'll shoot two.
Yep, Robinson's fifth. He's done for tonight and possibly and pretty much for the season.
Outstanding freshman season for Chris Robinson. Comes a disappointing end tonight.
I mean, I haven't seen anything, not much from a freshman like this, so congrats to Chris Robinson on a successful year for a freshman who got basically thrown into this after Cordell and Jamal Littlejohn left.
89-58, 3 minutes and 35 seconds in the ball game. This is Carter Phillips on the free throw line. Good. Second opportunity. Makes it 91-58. Lane Hoover set to come in, the senior.
He's going in for Langdon Gibbons, who's possibly played his last minutes of basketball here at Lincolnton.
91-58, 3:33. Sage, three-point shot, barely hit anything. Rebound comes away to the Greyhounds. Mason Hawks, great point guard. He'll take it, distribute it, get it back out, come back out to Tucker. Tucker against Diaz. Diaz, Tucker up top, gives it to Chase Chandler. Back to Hawks. Hawks playing keep away, now Lane Hoover out to guard him.
Yeah, just burning clock here.
2:53, straight to the basket, underhanded shot, good, he drew a foul.
Mason Hawks putting on a show with the crossover on Lane Hoover, and he gets an and one here.
So quick as Jacob Dixon comes in for the Lincolnton Wolves.
Yeah, replaces Robbie Cowley, so that means Sage is the only starter left in this ballgame for the Wolves. Won't be much longer, as it looks like Donnie Thompson's going to check in soon. I believe this will be for Sage.
Thompson, the senior, headed to Gardner-Webb on a football scholarship. Comes in for Surratt. And that is it.
Big standing ovation for Lincolnton. He's done a lot for this Lincoln County community and just the spotlight he's put on these two schools, East Lincoln and Lincolnton.
Here's Tayshawn Harris. Somebody stuck a hand in. He's fouled.
It'll be a 1-1 now for the Wolves.
Just wasn't to be. I mean, from the very beginning, Smoke, it got out of hand, and Lincolnton never recovered.
Yeah, just couldn't get anything going, and I think it kind of they had Lincolnton shell shock there.
I think
they just weren't able to get out of that hole.
That pressure defense, the turnovers, the points they created off the turnovers, just something that Lincolnton never could withstand, and it just got too far out of hand too quick. Here's Carter Phillips. Inside, that was Casey Holm, missed the shot with 2 minutes and 25 seconds left. Lane Hoover's going to take it. He'll get it picked his pocket from behind, but the ball will still belong to Lincolnton, though.
And if I'm North Surry here, I want to know why Carter Phillips is still in this game. I mean, you want to get him ready for Tuesday. Don't want anything to happen in these last few minutes if you're Coach King, you know?
Inbounds to Hoover. Hoover, a three-point shot, air ball. Missed nothing but the other side of the backboard. 2:15 to go. Jacob Harrison has come in. Carter Phillips is still in there. Chase Chandler is in there. Simmons is in there. Also Casey Hall. I think Forney's come in for Lincolnton, has he not?
Yeah, and also Reed Stanley and Mason Gwynn are looking to make their first appearances at the ballgame for North Surry. Probably coming in for the starters.
They'll call a timeout. Yeah, we'll break as well. Maybe one more time. Back in a moment. High school basketball, 10:50 a.m. KBCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app on your mobile device. Back in a moment.
Dine in, carry out, or use their convenient drive-through window at Mitchum's Kitchen in Vail. You'll find Northbrook's finest in food. As a matter of fact, the finest food anywhere.
And for a special treat, order one of their big bloomin' onions. From barbecue to fish to steaks, hamburgers and hot dogs, they've got it all at Bishop's Kitchen in Vail, open for breakfast too. And be sure to like them on Facebook for their specials and Sunday lunch menus. And they do catering no matter how big or small. Call Mitchum's Kitchen today, located at the intersection of Highway 27 West and Highway 274 in Vail.
I said where I come from, it's
150 left. It is North Surry 94, Lincolnton 58. First Federal Savings Bank scoreboard. All subs in now. They've cleared the benches. Both coaches have. Clock will wind on down. Season for Lincolnton will end. Greyhounds will advance. Jacob Dixon comes away with a loose ball. Forney is going to dribble into forecourt. He may take it, lose it, give it back out to Diaz. Diaz back in the corner to Forney, back to Diaz. Diaz loses it on the floor. Whistle. 1-1. Foul will be on Jacob Harrison. 1:16 left on the clock. Cameron Smith will come in. Ethan Simmons out. Good night for that starter as well.
Yeah. He played a nice defense on Sage Surratt and got the rebounds and a couple assists. Nice night for the man with the mullet, trying to bring it back.
Bring it on back. Diaz free throw, no good. Thompson with the rebound. Big Donnie Thompson off the glass. Missed it short, missed it again. Still trying to fight for it. Diaz with it, good. 94-60, 62 seconds left in the game. All reserves in there now. This is Reed Stanley. He puts up a shot. It's no good. Forney, rebound, but he steps out of bounds. It belonged to the Greyhounds.
Now we have another guy checking in for the Greyhounds. That is going to be Ryan Ward.
They played everybody on their bench except Evan Marion.
Oh, why you got to hate on Evan?
I know.
Right, I think he's checking in.
Down to 49 seconds. Long three, right side, no good. Missed by Mason Gwynn with 39 seconds. Forney to Diaz to Hoover.
It's time to take a three.
Big Donnie Thompson, three, missed it, nothing but air. 25 seconds, 94-60. Three, long one out there, no good. Missed by Stanley. Forney with the board. Hoover came away with the loose ball. Down to 12 seconds, 10 seconds. Donnie Thompson, crowd on their feet for North Surry. Thompson, lane, missed the shot, gets his board back up, no good. 1 second, shot, Forney, no good. That is a ball game. North Surry, 94. Lincolnton 60. That wraps up the year 25-2 for the Wolves. Greyhounds advance to Tuesday night. Back in a moment with the Marburger Chrysler Jeep Dodge of Shelby postgame show. High school basketball, 10:50 a.m. KDCBroadcasting.com, the Ustream app on your mobile device. Back in a moment, everybody.
Cornbread and chicken, where I come from.
Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton will brighten your smiles with professional cosmetic dentistry and smile enhancement procedures for everyone. Even Duke fans will smile at the work of this Tar Heel. The office of Dr. John L. Cloninger III is located at 904 Doncha Drive. For an appointment, call 704-735-0765. That's 704-735-0765. And John III says best wishes to all high school athletes.
Maybe a punctuation mark on a career night for Bryce Johnson.
ATV fans, the 2017 Yamaha Grizzly and Kodiak 700s are at Full Throttle Power Sports in Lowell. The more powerful than ever Grizzly is engineered for the all-day trail excursions on the toughest terrain. And the Kodiak 700 delivers class-best performance and value, starting at just $69.99. Visit Full Throttle Power Sports today. Yamaha ATVs, real world tough. Full Throttle Power Sports, exit 22 at I-85 in Lowell.
You don't pull a mask off an old Lone Ranger and you don't mess around with Jim.
breakfast time is the right time to be at the Home Place Restaurant, Highway 27, 2 miles west of Lincolnton. Check out their breakfast specials this month. Get your choice of a breakfast sandwich along with tea or coffee for just $3.99. But that's not all. Try their Big Country Breakfast. 2 eggs, your choice of bacon, sausage, liver mush, and a pancake. All for just $4.25 at the Home Place Restaurant. Highway 27, 2 miles west of Lincolnton. Now open for Sunday lunch, too.
Whenever you need me, I'll be there.
Now's the time to head to West End Sales in Vail for some great deals on Coyote. Like the Coyote UTV with top and winch starting at $11,900 and get 0% financing. And see the new Coyote 3510 34 horsepower tractor, only $17,900. And the big Coyote RX Series 4-wheel drive tractor with cab and loader starting at $37,000. And see the big line of Big Tex trailers, over 40 in stock, 3.99% financing for 54 months with approved credit. West End Sales, 110 North Highway 18 in Vail, online at westendsales.com.
Sleep apnea is the interruption of sleep by a blockage to breathing. 8 million Americans go undiagnosed for sleep apnea. Dr. John L. Cloninger III of Lincolnton can help you with sleep apnea problems. John III is a member of the American Academy of Dental Sleep Medicine. He can help you now overcome the symptoms of obstructive sleep apnea, such as excessive daytime sleep, loud snoring, episodes of breathing cessation where you stop breathing, dry mouth and sore throat, morning headaches, insomnia, attention problems, and more. John III is concerned that patients don't know there are treatments for obstructive sleep apnea, from CPAP to dental appliances or even surgery. John III offers a free consultation for anyone with symptoms of sleep apnea. Just call 704-735-0765 or come by 904 Doncha Drive in Lincolnton to make an appointment. Sleep longer, smile brighter, live happier. Let Dr. John L. Cloninger III put his 21 years of dentistry experience to work for you.
You don't pull a mask off an old Lone Ranger and you don't mess around with Jim.
Think your dream home is out of reach? Think again. At Silver Point Homes in Lincolnton, they provide quality custom construction and the luxury amenities you want at an exceptional value. Whether you're a first-time home buyer or an empty nester looking to downsize, we have the perfect home for you. Visit SilverPointHomes.com to learn more or stop by our Lincolnton Sales Center to tour our model homes. Let our friendly staff help you visualize your dream. Silver Point Homes, making your dream home a reality. New models now on display. Silver Point Homes, East Main Street, Lincolnton.
All right, Evan and Derek back with you on the Marburger Chrysler Jeep Dodge of Shelby postgame show. Final score, North Surry 94, Lincolnton 60. And Smoke, again, just got out of hand too quick, couldn't recover, couldn't stop the bleeding. The defense, pressure defense, the turnovers, the points off the turnovers, just snowballed, an avalanche, really, and never in the ballgame tonight.
Yeah, and Lincolnton just got off the gate bad, and I think that just sunk them in, and they just couldn't recover from it. Because North Surry is just so talented. Derek, the only other team I could, high school I could say that's this fundamental in basketball is Alexander Central. That's how good this North Surry team is. I just compared them to a 4A school that's doing good things in the 4A level. So that shows you how good this North Surry team is. And, wow, I'm at a loss for words because how amazing they just shut down Lincolnton. They just shut them down completely, causing turnovers left and right. I was having a hard time keeping up with the stats because they were getting so many fast break points. They were, when they allowed the points, they would go back down the court before Lincolnton could get set up, and they were getting points. I mean, whenever Lincolnton had something going, then it would be shut right back down by North Surry.
Wolves finished the season 24-2. North Surry goes to 25-4, and they will play the winner of Shelby and Lake Norman Charter at their place Tuesday night for round number 4. Final stats, Evan?
Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. We'll do Lincolnton first. Tyshawn Harris, 4 points, 1 board. Taheem Forney had 2 rebounds late in the game. Chris Robinson, tough night for the freshman, 4 points, 5 rebounds, and 2 assists, and got fouled out. Jeffrey Diaz had 1 rebound. Sade Surratt, 28 points. 7 assists, 6 rebounds. For his standard, that's below average, but still a good night for him.
Robbie Cowie, another quiet night, 8 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists. Young Sherrill, extremely quiet night after having a great start to this playoffs, 4 points and 3 boards. Donnie Thompson, 6 rebounds, all coming off in the last minute, trying to get makes off of his misses. Langdon Givens had a pretty good night, 10 points, 1 assist, 1 rebound, and Skylar Evans with 1 rebound. Now with North Surry, lots of stats all over the place. Mason Hawks, the point guard, had 18 points, 11 assists, and 4 rebounds, so a nice double-double for him. Carter Phillips, 35 points, 6 boards, and 5 assists. Then you go over, look down the stat sheet. Kendall Tucker, 19 points, 4 boards, 2 assists. Casey Hall had himself a night, too. 15 points, 5 boards, 2 assists. Chase Chandler, 2 points and an assist coming off the bench. Ryan Ward, 1 rebound. Avery Smith, 1 rebound. Ethan Simmons, the guy with the mullet, bringing the mullet back. He had 2 points and 3 rebounds, 2 assists. And Jacob Harrison got a 3-pointer early on and a rebound. And that does it for the stats for tonight's game.
Sage Surratt, what can you say about him? The enemy for 3 years. His East Lincoln team handled the Wolves in both football for 3 straight years. Beat them 4 times last year in basketball. Comes to Lincoln in the offseason with the intentions of bringing the Wolves to a state championship appearance in football and or basketball. Outstanding seasons in both football and basketball come to an end deep in the playoffs, but the guy's been meant a lot, as you pointed out, for the entire county, that side, this side, on to Wake Forest, but an outstanding young man, great athlete, representative of all Lincoln County.
And you know, Derek, I think, you know, we're not realizing this till maybe next year, but this is, I know this gets thrown around a lot, but I think this is truly the end of an era here in high school sports in Lincoln County, because during these years of Chaz and Sage, it's like everyone tried to compete to be the best here. It really felt like everyone was really competing like I have never seen them before here in Lincoln County. It felt like they're more even, because usually we think Lincolnton's the powerhouse that, and they'll never be stopped, but with Chaz and Sage, they brought East Lincoln onto the forefront and finally got the state championship, made them the most relevant thing in Lincoln County. And that wanted Lincolnton wanted to be better than that, and I think, you know, if North or West were in the conference some years, I think things might be a little closer with them too. Or West is in the conference, but I think West has slowly gotten better. But we are not, I don't think within the next 25 years we are going to see an athlete or athletes like the Surratts, because that's how special they are. And it proves, because one is a parade All-American player of the year and the other is going to be playing football at Wake Forest.
North Surry fans down on that end of the gym crowded around congratulating their guys as they come out of the lobby, as they should. West End Sales player of the game, Smoke.
You know, Mason Hawks and Carter Phillips made it hard for us. It's like they're competing for player of the game. But Carter Phillips had a tremendous, tremendous night. 35 points, 6 rebounds, 5 assists. What a night for him. Mason Hawks, if it was any other night, he would have gotten the player of the game presented by West End Sales and Vail. But congratulations to Carter Phillips, as I think, if anything, I believe Shelby might be playing North Surry. So that's going to be interesting Tuesday night to see what happens. Going to be some good guard play between Mason Hawks and Quay Kimball.
And should Shelby prevail, that'll be on 1390 AM, 101.5 FM, WOHS on Tuesday. Kevin Hastings, I assume, will make that trip to North Surry. Maybe you go with him.
Well,
I don't know.
Well, he just said now you got to go to North Surry on Tuesday. So
there you go, yeah. Big guy.
Hey,
you'll get to see
break.
This team again.
Yeah, it's spring break, so I have no problems.
Well, at least you will have seen this team and know what they're about if they play Shelby.
They're going to play Shelby.
I'm
going to have to tell Kevin the awesomeness of Ethan Simmons' mullet. I think we should start a fan club.
No doubt about it. Get a picture and tweet it out for us. All right. Well, so I'll see you next Friday night for, guess what? Baseball season is here, my friend.
Hey, and I'm really excited about this baseball season here because I think all 4 teams could be competitors and make some good baseball games throughout this year. East Lincoln got Alec Burleson, who we saw in basketball, but he's a pitcher. He could be the ace. As long as you got an ace, you got a shot in baseball. West Lincoln, they mostly kept everybody. And Lincolnton, you know, Cowie, he had a tremendous year in American Legion.
Sure did.
And it's going to be interesting to
see
what
happens. Get the cover off the ball over the summer. Terrible.
He did. And North Lincoln, even though they lost a lot, they still got a lot of good young guys on their team as well. So I'm very excited. This is probably the best all-around sport for Lincoln County.
And we will have the game next Friday night. It'll be Fred T. Ford at West Lincoln. 7 o'clock will be the first pitch from Vail. Pregame show at 6:45. You and I for baseball. Let's hope the weather stays the way it has been the remainder of the spring as we get to baseball season.
Well, now watch. It's going to be extremely cold next Friday.
All right. Well, Evan, enjoy your trip to North Surry on Tuesday night as Shelby will take on this bunch. Good luck to the Golden Lions. This is a very good basketball team.
Yes, extremely good. And this might be the team that could beat East Rutherford. That's how good they are.
All right. For Evan, this is Derek saying so long. Have a great rest of the weekend. We'll see you back for more sports next week on KDCBroadcasting.com. Good night, everybody.
It's a Husqvarna closeout sale on the remaining 2016 model Husqvarna mowers, including the Husqvarna zero-turn mowers at Al Lane Kubota and Motorsports in Lincolnton. Come on in now for their preseason specials. Ask about 0% financing for up to 42 months. Right now, there's a big selection to choose from, and Al Lane is having a chainsaw clearance sale. Prices have been slashed. Get ready for springtime with a trip to Al Lane Kubota and Motorsports, Highway 27 east of Lincolnton at the Highway 73 intersection and online at AlLaneMotorsports.com.
I said where I come from, it's cornbread and chicken where I come from.
The President's Day sale is underway at Renato Automall in Shelby. I cannot tell a lie. You can't beat the deals found at Renato Automall in Shelby. Come in now and take 0% APR financing up to 66 months plus $1,000 cash bonus on the 2016 Kia Optimus. Take $9,000 off MSRP on the new 2016 GMC Sierra 1500 truck. And buy a new 2017 Honda HR-V LX for $183 a month, 0.9% financing up to 60 months. At Renato Auto Mall, 4423 East Dixon Boulevard in Shelby, right below the Cleveland Mall.
First Federal Savings Bank has been serving Lincoln County for over 75 years.